this is Sam. Welcome to new video. I am bugged sitting at home, and that's when I came across this tag video, which is called frustrating book tag video. Frustrating times, frustrating tag. So without further ado, let's get into this video. This tag was originally done by PM Readers, but I saw Liz doing it from For Booking Out Loud. She didn't tag anybody, but she kept it open, saying that anybody can do this tag, so I just picked it up. You know the drill, there are a set of questions and you have to answer them. So let's get started. The first question is, name a book you predicted would be 5-star but wasn't. That's my last read, The Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett. I had lots of expectations from this book and I thought it would be a 5-star, but it was just, I can say 3.5 stars. It's about twin girls, how they lead a separate lives, and I didn't find it that appealing as it was so much hyped into 2020, but this was not a 5-star for me. What book had a great beginning but an ending that let you down? I would tell The Strange Dreamer and The Muse of Nightmare by Lenny Taylor, Strange Dreamer series. When I read The Strange Dreamer, I was very much looking forward for the sequel. But when I read The Muse of Nightmare, I was let down with the ending. Do you have any book with pretty cover but an ugly spine? I don't know what ugly spine, but there is no spine at all in this book, which is The Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka. This is not original book, I guess. Do you have any book series that doesn't match? Maybe some are paperback and some are hardcover, or maybe the cover design may change halfway through the series. Does it bother you? This only, actually, Strange the Dreamer. I have the first book hardcover and the second book paperback, but that doesn't bother me much. The next question is there a book from your youth you can remember parts of but cannot remember the name or find anywhere? Yes, Sidney Sheldon's book. I have read them so much when I started reading that I remember those were crime thriller, mystery novels, but I don't remember the titles. I don't remember. The stories are kind of mixed up. I seriously don't remember anything. The next question is, are there any books you are certain you have read but cannot remember anything about them? I'm sure I have read Paulo Coelho's Pilgrimage and Valkyries, but I don't remember anything about them. That is strange, yeah. Next question is, have you ever recommended a book you love to someone and they started telling you everything they didn't like about it? Does it bother you? In other words, do your feelings get hurt when someone doesn't love the one of your favorite books? See, I'm a booktuber, I recommend book, and I shouldn't get offended if somebody don't like my favorite book, because actually I do that. When somebody tells me the favorite book, I start telling them what I didn't like about that book. Now I'm getting the feeling that shit, what I have done. Sorry if I have offended somebody with their favorite book. It really doesn't bother me because it's individual choice, and I read varied genres and I don't like certain books, and that's quite natural. It shouldn't bother anyone. It's personal choice. 8th question is, what is your worst experience loaning a book to someone? In college, I didn't have that much physical copy. I had only one book that time, which was the first book which I bought, is The Alchemist. But my friend took that with the bargain of this book, The Fountainhead. I haven't finished this book actually. Every architect should read, they say, but sorry. I have read around 300 pages, but it didn't appeal so much. So he took The Alchemist book and he gave me this book. It stayed with me and The Alchemist stayed with him. So again, I bought this Alchemist this year. 9th question is, show me some of your impulse buys that you have never read. You know the ones you bought at the midnight while online shopping, or when you were walking through a bookstore and the magic of all the books made you grab a few too many, and we can't forget all those books at such a good price that somehow make into our shopping bags. I have them. The Ramchandra series by Amish Tripathi. I never thought I would read this book because I had my ebook copy also, but I was getting them at such a good price that I couldn't stop myself from buying them. Like, I got these 3 for 3.32 or something on Flipkart, and they made to my shelf. And with that, this also came. Jojo Moyes, Me Before You. I don't know if I'll be able to read this series. I haven't bought any other book, but I bought this one. Yes. These were my impulsive buys. Last question. Just to make you hate me a little bit more, how many unread books are on your shelves? 33. Yeah, 33. Will not go to ebooks or audiobooks. It will be huge number. But you know, that's the thing. We still keep buying books. I am unemployed. Still, I beg my husband and my mom for money to buy more books. You know, that's the thing about book lover. You keep buying more books, and those are never enough for us. That's all for today, guys. This is really fun video, and I love doing this video. There is nothing that you should tag someone or something, but I know few people who will love doing this video, so I'll be tagging them. The first one will be Jessica from Just Book Girl TV, and second will be Elizabeth from Time to Unwind. Third will be Isha from Saran Shorter, Priya from Liviosa Reader, Manya from Devouring Books, Ankita from Bookish Mentor, and this little cutie from Worlds Not Words. That's all for today, guys. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. Hakuna Matata.